Welcome to the fourth lecture of Principles of Management. We are still on Unit 1. You will recall that in the preceding three lectures, we discussed the meaning of the management and we discussed the definitions given by various authors. We also discussed what are the characteristics of management. Also, we engaged in a kind of a discussion of if management is a science or it's an art, in terms of which discipline it falls in, which stream it falls in, whether it is a science or an art. And we concluded that it is a bit of both. It is both science and an art. Also, we discussed the objectives of management and the levels of management. In levels of management, I tried to tell you about the top management, which is like, you know, when you talk of presidents and vice president and CXO positions, you talk of top management. When you talk of plant managers or divisional managers or regional managers, you talk of middle management and junior level of management or supervisory cadre, which you say, or operative management is when you talk of shop floor engineers, assistant managers, you know, sales officers. Or even in like in a shop floor, I remember there was a position called foreman position, who was the senior most worker and the leader of a gang or a team, foreman. So levels of management. I gave you the example of Indian Oil Corporation and Reliance Petroleum. Both, I gave you examples from the retail sales division, and I explained to you how different are their number of levels in the two companies. And we discussed the top management, roles and responsibilities, middle management, roles and responsibilities, frontline managers, supervisors or junior managers, their roles and responsibilities. Functional management, we discussed a bit about what is production management, marketing management, financial management, HR management. And we talked about the core functions of management as described by Peter Drucker. And the final session of unit of lecture number 3 was managerial process. I explained to you the management functions in terms of planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So today we will take up 10 managerial roles which were defined, which have been defined by Henry Mintzberg in 1971. Henry Mintzberg lives in Canada. He is a professor in a university in Canada, in the Quebec region, and he has given 10 managerial roles, and it has been his categorization of 10 managerial roles can be, you know, we can club them into three kind of headings: interpersonal roles, informational roles, and decision making roles. Okay, so Henry Mintzberg's this theory was criticized by some people because it was said that he carried out the research only in very few organizations, only I think in five organizations. But this was a study which was done over a extended period of time, and by and large, all the roles which have been enumerated and discussed by Henry Mintzberg, to my mind, he has covered everything about managerial function. Before we move to managerial function, I would like to dwell upon this term called role. What is meant by role? See, in carrying out responsibilities of planning, organizing, leading, controlling, manager take on different roles. You must have heard that a person, let us take a take the case of a person who is a lawyer. So when he is in the court, he is playing the role of a lawyer. Just like, you know, in the movies, Amjad Khan played the role of Gabbar. In some other movie, he played the role of a police inspector. So dacoit in one movie and policeman in the other movie. So let's take the case of lawyer. In the court, he is playing the role of an advocate. He is presenting the case on behalf of his client before the judge. And he is reading the law books. He is preparing the brief. Okay. So once he goes back home and he talks to his wife, and they mutually sit down together and the wife says, okay, these are the challenges we are facing, or this is the plan. So he's playing the role of a householder, isn't it? Householder along with his wife. When he's talking to his children, he's playing the role of a father. When he's meeting his parents, look, asking them about their health, their well-being, extending all courtesies and respect to his parents, he's playing the role of a son. Okay, and when he's in his club with his friends, he's playing the role of a friend. When he's meeting his sister or his brother, he's playing the role of a brother. So similarly, managers play different role, but a role is a set of behavioral expectation, a behavioral expectation, or you can say it is a set of activity that a person is expected to perform. So many people they interchangeably use role and responsibilities. These are two different. Role is a set of behavioral expectations or a set of activities that a person is expected to perform. So a prime minister is expected to perform expected to exhibit certain behavior, and he is expected to carry out certain set of activities in his cabinet. He is the first among equals. So managerial roles, they also get into various categories. A manager's role is interpersonal roles. For example, they will be based upon various interaction with the other people. Okay. So when making a decision, a manager may take the role of an entrepreneur. He may take the role of a resource allocator. He may take up the role of somebody who is trying to manage the conflict in the organization or who is trying to negotiate. So all I am trying to tell you is, role is a set of behavioral expectation or a set of activities that a person is expected to perform. You have to keep this in mind. So role does not mean responsibility. Role does not mean authority or anything. So just like I said, when there is a person is a doctor in the clinic, he is a doctor, is performing the role of a doctor. When he's at home, he's performing the role of a husband or a father or a brother or a son. Okay, let's move forward and discuss the managerial roles. Managerial roles actually refer to the specific actions which are performed by various managers. And as I said in my previous discourse, that managers play multiple roles in their careers, you know, at different points in time. Just like a father plays the role of a breadwinner, he plays the role of an officer or a worker at its workplace, and then at home he plays some other roles. And managerial roles, they indicate what managers actually do. Henry Milsberg, he divided all the roles played by managers, all the roles played by manager into three different sections. The first, he said, are interpersonal roles. Second, informational roles. And third is decisional roles or decision-making roles. Now, I'll tell you a brief about what is meant by interpersonal roles. These roles are mainly concerned with the interpersonal and social relationships of manager with their subordinates and others. And this role is performed by manager. It can be ceremonial. It can be symbolic in nature. And it facilitates manager in developing positive interpersonal relationship, which usually grows out of the formal authority. In this interpersonal roles, there are roles of figurehead, leader, and liaison roles. We will discuss each one of them later on. Informational role means the interpersonal roles of management that aims at gathering necessary information from different sources. So informational role, it focuses on processing and transmitting the information to others. So, as the name suggests, that informational role, it focuses mainly on information management activities like sourcing, checking, disseminating. So, this is about informational role. And then the third role is the decision-making role. In the decision-making role or decisional role, managers take decisions based on inputs received through interpersonal or informational roles. So, interpersonal roles, they provide information to the manager, while informational role process and store the same. And finally, the decision role is taken. So, decision role means it makes a productive use of the information. So, perhaps decisional roles are perhaps the most important roles performed by managers. As their decisions, they determine the performance and progress of the organization. In decisional roles, there are managers. The decisional roles of managers are like the role of an entrepreneur, disturbance handler, resource allocator, negotiator. And if you see the decision making process is essentially identifying the problem, defining the problem, identifying possible solutions, selecting one or more alternatives among many solutions, implementing the plan, and later on to check if the problem has been resolved or the problem has been solved. So, the role of a manager, the three distinct role and the decision making process I have explained to you. One question which students ask me when I am in their face to face classes, they ask me, sir, which of the role is most important? Interpersonal role is most important, informational role is more important, or decisional role is most important? See, interpersonal role becomes part and parcel of you once you are appointed to that position. You become a figurehead, you become a leader, you have to do all the liaison work. So there is very little you can do by improving this role or not improving this role, except that if you perform in this role badly, you will not be considered much of a manager. Perhaps as the managerial levels go up, interpersonal role becomes important, because only the strategic decisions are taken by the top leaders. So they are more of figureheads, more of leaders, more of the liaison person, you know. Decision-making roles are roles which are performed by, let us say, a plant manager or a factory manager. He has to take a decision, how much should be the production of this shift, how much should I go for two shifts or should I work in one shift? How should I allocate resource? So no role can be said to be more important. At different levels, some role take precedence over other role. At one point in time, interpersonal roles may take center stage. At other times, decisional roles may take a center stage. So it is very difficult to say which role is more important. All these roles are equally important. We have given 10 roles. All these roles are equally important. So interpersonal roles, there are three: figurehead, leader, and liaison role. Information role, there are three again: the role of a monitor, disseminator, and spokesperson or a spokesman. Decision role, there are four: entrepreneur, distribution handler, resource allocator, and negotiator. All four roles are equally important. So let's discuss the managerial role as a leader, or his role as a liaison person, and his role as figurehead. So figurehead, as the, you know, we say that the Queen Elizabeth is the figurehead monarch of the Commonwealth. This indicates the role of manager as a representative of the organization, For example, the president is the figurehead of India. Of course, in terms of protocol, President of India is at, he's the first man of the country. He's the most respected leader of the country. He is at the top of everyone. He is ahead of everyone when it comes to paying respect, when it comes to according protocol. President of India is number one, but he is the figurehead. So the Prime Minister and the other ministers, the Council of Ministers, they exercise authority, it is said, on behalf of the President. Although in reality, President is just the figurehead. So managers play this role at every level in some form when activity, any ceremonial, when activities of ceremonial nature are required. For example, like we just had Airtel Marathon in Delhi. So the chief marketing officer of Airtel, he performed the role of a person who flagged off the marathon. Okay. So similarly, in a factory, the factory manager is the figurehead. If there is any function, let us say on Vishwakarma Day, when workers, they worship their tools and implements, then on that day, the factory manager, the factory head of the factory, he is the senior most person, and as figurehead, he performs the puja or all the duties. A CEO, chief executive officer of a bank, when the new set of probationary officers are inducted in the company, when he greets the trainees upon the successful completion of the training program, he is playing the role of a figurehead. So, but this kind of a activity is prestigious, of course, prestigious. It's a very respectable activity, but it lacks serious communication and important decision-making requirements. By communication, I mean the communication aspect within the company. And since this is a ceremonial work, this work is symbolic in nature, it is more of a work attached to the position, and it is more aligned to the position than to an individual's personal identity or his personality, you know. So, but nevertheless, managers perform the role of figureheads at one time or the other. Second role which the managers have to perform is the role of a leader. So, of course, we will come to the debate of leadership versus management. Are all managers leaders? Are all leader managers? This is a debate, but suffice to say that there is an element of leadership in all managerial position. This role specifies the relationship between managers and subordinates, and it focuses on effective coordination and control of subordinates' work by the manager. Depending upon the circumstances and requirement, the managers may directly or indirectly control the activities of subordinates. For example, hiring and training of subordinates by managers, it may necessitate direct contact between them. So, you know, in contrast, implementation of predetermined quality goals and time management at work, it may not require direct interaction between managers and subordinates. But the leadership role is shaped by the manager's official position in the firm, but equally by his individual identity. Figurehead role, we said, is not so much shaped by individual identity. The leadership role is often shaped by individual identity. Now, the question of leader, every managerial position, does it require a leadership element? Yes, of course. Anybody who is a manager and who is managing a team necessarily have to have basic leadership skills. And without those basic leadership skills, managers will be ineffective. Third function which we talk about is the liaison function. This function is an important function because manager needs to interact with the external stakeholders as well as internal stakeholders. For example, a head of stores, he may call a vendor to ascertain the exact date of arrival of a raw material to the stores. So, and he may also like to work closely with the vendors and develop the vendor as a whole, so that vendor becomes more capable. He is able to contribute to the just-in-time philosophy of the organization. I am talking from the perspective of supply chain management. For example, a production manager, he may liaison with the marketing manager as to, please give me a forecast of what product in what sizes in how many numbers will you use in the next 6 months so that I can plan my inventory. Also, the managers need to interact with the outside departments. I remember that when I was a officer trainee and I was posted in a plant in Kanpur, in an LPG plant, the power outages were very rapid and our plant was under great stress to produce, to bottle more and more LPG cylinders, because in the whole of Eastern UP there were only two plants. One was in Allahabad and one was in Uttar Pradesh, and on these two plants the entire Eastern UP market from Allahabad to Gorakhpur, Varanasi, or the entire market depended only upon two plants. So power outage meant stoppage of work, or it meant that we had to resort to running, generating our own electricity by use of diesel, which was of course expensive. So the chief plant manager of our plant, he used to be regularly in touch with the high officials of electricity board. Other than that, our plant was located in an area which was away from the city. So there were some, we were having two shifts from 6 in the morning to 2 in the afternoon and from 2 in the afternoon to 10 at night. So workers needed to go out after 10 p.m. at night, especially during winters when there was lot of, when the roads were very quiet, okay, and there were stray instances of thefts and robberies. So our plant manager, he used to be in close contact with the police and he would impress upon them that they need to patrol that area, or he would talk to the street lighting department that, you know, they needed to improve the lighting on the roads so that, you know, the instances of robberies were reduced. So managers constantly need to be in touch with external stakeholders. Similarly, our finance manager was all the time in touch with the State Bank of India branch, because we would depend upon State Bank of India branch for our banking transactions. And his liaison with the State Bank was so good that eventually State Bank of India agreed to have a small branch of their own inside our plant. So they posted one person and he would look after, you know, exclusively meant he would come, there was a staff of one or two persons, and they would operate from our plant. So these are these three roles: the role of a liaison, the role of leadership role, and the role of figurehead, one who represents the organization during ceremonial functions, or if one has to speak to the press, figurehead. So if I also, just to give you another example, the plant manager, whenever there was a meeting of government officials in which the civil supplies were being discussed, and there used to be an evening tea, or there was a DM would call senior managers or various many members of his team for tea, he would also call the manager of Indian Oil Corporation. So our plant manager was the figurehead of our plant and he would represent the company in that meeting. So this is these three roles I have described. Now we will go to the other roles, managerial roles, as defined by Henry. Let us discuss the second category of role of managers or the managerial roles, which is called the informational roles. Informational roles. So we have, it is subdivided into monitor, disseminator and spokesperson role. Monitor. One of the most important roles, managerial roles, involves gathering information on events or occurrences in environment that affect the organization in one way or the other. Okay, this role relates to, is closely related to the first role, which was the interpersonal role, because of the interpersonal relationships developed by managers in the course of their work, collection of information is possible. If there is no interpersonal role, then there can be no real informational role. Think of the situation wherein a manager who has got interpersonal role as a figurehead, and he is interacting with the workers on a ongoing basis, and he comes to know about some kind of a dissatisfaction between a set of workers. Now this dissatisfaction could be a genuine dissatisfaction due to, let us say, change in working hours, or a change in behavior due to introduction of new systems or new machine, or a sense of unease among workers because of any new event which has taken place. So, because the manager is directly interacting with the workers, all classes of worker, whether they are junior level workers, they are operators, or they are supervisors, or they are foremen or chargemen or machinist, and he is in touch with them, he is able to sense a sense of discomfort among the workers. So he is constantly monitoring, and this will help in taking a proactive action, help him make a plan which will bring back the confidence in the workforce. Because smooth management, smooth workflow is only possible if there exists a very fine, a very harmonious and a peaceful relationship between management and the working class. More the clash, less the productivity. Smoother the relationship, more efficiency, more effectiveness. So monitoring of new activities, new development which is taking place in the market is equally important. So I recall during the mid 90s, I was working in a public sector unit undertaking called Indian Oil Corporation, which is of course one of the best and the brightest companies, not only in India, among the best petroleum retail companies in the world. At that point in time in Delhi, there was a task force which was set up at the instance of Supreme Court, and which was looking into the ways and means of setting up CNG, compressed natural gas, or which you also called, which comes to the house as piped natural gas, as CNG stations in Delhi. So Gas Authority India Limited was tasked with the job of bringing up or constructing the first CNG station. I was also a part of the task force, and I was deputed by Indian Oil Corporation to work along with the officials of IGL in this. And we had set up the first station outside Safdarjung Hospital at a station called Bhatia Service Station. Now, what is the impact of new CNG station on an ancillary unit in Delhi, which is, let us say, making compressors, or which is making pumps, or any entrepreneur who senses a role for himself in providing to the market CNG converter kits only if an organization or a person is able to monitor the environment, the rapid change in the environment, only he can make a perspective plan to take best advantage of such a situation. While we were engaged in this, at that point in time, I am talking of the mid-90s, when Reliance had a refinery unit, but they had absolutely no clue, or they had no plans to set up any fuel station, or they had no plans to come up with the retail. Even then, their managers were closely monitoring the progress of the first CNG station in Delhi. So it is very important. It is very important. Today, of course, many companies, many more companies, I think Adanis are already, they already have a blueprint for setting up several CNG stations. Of course, after that, IGL, Indraprastha Gas, came up and it has set up more than 100 stations, 100 CNG stations in Delhi, which looks after the CNG requirement of the motoring public in Delhi. But what I mean to say that monitoring, scanning the environment, scanning the groups of internal stakeholders, everything is one of the most important managerial roles. What is meant by, this is the monitoring role, what is meant by disseminator? This role involves sharing of special and significant information by the managers with the subordinates. So managers usually have gathered some useful facts and figures from outsiders. They may like to transmit the same, not all, some of it or most of it, depending upon what the, how the manager views it, to other people in the organization. They may also like to filter this information and disclose it in a selective manner to some privileged person. For example, if there is a merger, if two of the competing companies are merging, so the top manager may come to know about it through some banks or through some outside consultant, and he may like to share this information with some of the middle managers. So similarly, I said a supervisor may like to alert his superiors about the strike call which is likely to be made by a trade union. Disseminator means to share the information. It is the role of the manager to decide what information he wants to share with whom, how much information he wants to share, how much information he does not want to share. There are times when you may not want to share all the information with your team because a part of the information can have a demoralizing impact on the team. So there is no way you want to demoralize your team. So monitoring and disseminating of the information I've discussed with you. Third function is spokesperson. What is meant by spokesperson? A person who speaks on behalf of his department or his work unit, both within and outside the organization. So if the government, if the union government wants to make an announcement on the new vaccine, new COVID vaccine, it will decide who will address the nation. Like Prime Minister has addressed the nation 2 days back, or the health minister may be the spokesperson, or it is possible that the head of ICMR may like to give this information, or the principal scientific advisor to the Prime Minister may give this information, or Director General of Health Services may give this information. Similarly, we have World Health Organization. It may nominate the leader, the apex leader of India, to become spokesperson if there is any information regarding COVID-19 which is to be given. We have seen that Army has its spokesperson at various command levels. They are of the level of colonel or brigadier or lieutenant colonel. They are the ones who assume this public relation role. Also, there are times when an organization needs to proactively work with departments, the government departments. to safeguard the interest of the organization. I don't want to use the word lobbying, but oftentimes lobbying is necessary for obtaining critical resources for your own department. So spokesperson is a role which is normally, for example, when you are in an annual general meeting, the top manager, normally the managing director, chairman or the managing director of the company, he assumes the role of a spokesperson. When declaring financial figures, the chief financial officer or the director of finance may assume the role of a spokesperson. A spokesperson needs to give adequate information with clarity, and only that information which has a positive impact on the organization. A spokesperson has to be very, very careful before any information is transmitted through a formal or an informal channel. So these three roles are critical, vital roles of management. The final segment of decision of managerial roles is one which involves decision making. And decision making is actually it's a set of process. You need to define a problem and specify the problem, pinpoint the root cause of the problem. Once that is done, you need to identify possible solutions. You need to select one or more alternative, because there can be more than one solution to a problem, and you need to then make a plan, and you need to implement that plan, and then you need to do a cross check after some time if the solution which you implemented for that problem, is it working, is it not working. So in this decision making role, what are the various wide variety of roles played by managers? The first is the role of an entrepreneur. I remember I was working for Food Specialities Limited, which is now called Nestle, and I came across a position called product manager position. So I asked somebody, what is a product, what is the meant by a product manager? And later on, when I was working for another company, I came to know of something called category manager. So what is meant by a product manager? Like in Nestle, example, if you are product manager of the Maggi sub-brand of Nestle, that means you own that brand. That means the top line, which means the sales, and the bottom line, which means the profits, they are your responsibility. You don't own Nestle. Nestle is a very large multinational company. It is perhaps the biggest foods company of the world. It does not have any single owner. And a manager in no way is the owner of Nestle. And yet, he is considered as an entrepreneur. He is considered as somebody who owns that part of the brand. So the product manager of Maggi, and I am talking from my experiences in 1987, product manager of Maggi, he from conceptualization stage to the stage of rollout, to the stage of getting involved with the advertising, trade promotion, consumer promotion, designing the streamers and the buntings and the banners, he is involved with every single aspect of Maggi, whether it is Maggi Maggi sauce or Maggi ketchup or it is Maggi noodles. So this is entrepreneurship. He may not own that brand, he may not even own any share in the company, but he is as passionate about his role as if he's owner of that brand. So as a part of this role, managers usually design and initiate changes in their work unit to achieve desired improvement. Changes may involve introduction of a new technology, a new work practice, or a new work culture. That means you have power to introduce even a new work practice. So generally the information which is collected through the monitor role, it is used in performing the entrepreneur role. For example, in a company which believes in giving very high incentive to the top management, will also give that management full powers to introduce any scheme. I recall that in Indian Oil Corporation, it was generally left to the plant manager as to how would he manage most of the consumables. So he was given a particular target on consumables, and it was left for him to design any incentive scheme for his workers to ensure that all the consumables were used in a most effective manner. And all unnecessary expenditures were curtailed by good practices of the workforce. So companies like to empower their top managers to achieve the desired results. So this is the entrepreneurship role of a manager. Another role is disturbance handler. In this role, managers determine their response to work-related disturbances within organization, outside organization. So they assume this role whenever they face potentially serious disturbances. In situations, they quickly evaluate all solutions to the problem and they choose the best one to solve it. Managers can assume this role can come to center stage in case of, let us say, machinery breakdown. Let me give you an example of Indian Oil Corporation. So if the LPG head of a division, the LPG area manager, he comes to know that the central column of the carousel of one plant has broken down and the plant may not be in a position to bottle cylinders for next 3 or 4 or 5 days, and it will cause scarcity in the market, because LPG, when the era I am talking about is when the demand far outstrip the supply situation. So he has to take a call. He has to immediately talk to his counterpart in Western UP or in some other part of the country and ensure that his market is served by non-traditional supply chain. So if the plant at Allahabad has broken down, he is able to get some supplies from Mathura, or he can talk to somebody in Kanpur and his market can be taken care of. When disturbance takes place, this role, it takes precedence over all other roles. The role of distribution, the disturbance handler assumes greatest importance. Third role is the role of a resource allocator. All the time we have seen in any country, in any company, resources are not unlimited. Resources are scarce and the manager has to allocate funds and allocate resources. And resources could be human resource, it could be in terms of money to various units. Let me again come back to the example of LPG distribution. The supply or the logistics manager of the plant, outbound logistics, he has to ensure that he, because number of cylinders which are bottled is limited, it is not unlimited. So he has to allocate LPG cylinders to various markets in such a manner that there is some equitable level of distribution across all markets. This will require lot of ingenuity, and this will also require complete absence of personal biases and likes and dislikes. Resource allocation is sometimes called a thankless job, because if you allocate resource to a person, he feels that this was his matter of right, and if you deny somebody else those resources, he may consider you as a evil incarnate. Okay, for example, you know, if you have to, let us take the case of planning commission, or let us take the case of a company from head office, it has to allocate new trained officers to various regions, to eastern region, to western region, to southern region. So it has to allocate resource based upon the need of the region, and it has to ensure that no kind of bias comes into play when these resources are allocated. The fourth and the final role is the role of a negotiator. In this role, a manager is required to conduct negotiation with individuals or group to protect the interest of department or the work unit. So a sales manager or a area sales manager has to negotiate with his distributor for a sales target. First of all, he has to make the distributor agree to a particular sales target, and he not only has to ensure that the distributor agrees to the company's target willingly, he also pays the company on time. Similarly, when it comes to increasing the productivity of a plant, the plant management has to negotiate with the workmen, to the union. So plant manager may tell them that till now you have been producing X set of units. Now you have to produce X plus this set of unit because we have given you this machine. So negotiation. Negotiation takes place whenever there is a wage revision. Negotiation takes place. Negotiation takes place whenever the timing of a factory needs to be changed. Negotiation takes place when the office place has to be shifted. Because suppose the office is situated for many years at one particular location, and now the office or the factory is being situated in the outskirts, it would cause lot of discomfort to the employees who had already built or who have already taken on lease houses which is around their office, and now suddenly they will need to relocate. When you open a new unit, you need to transfer your officers. You have to negotiate with them. You have to incentivize them. Sometimes you have to cajole them. Sometimes, you know, you have to give them an increment. Sometimes you have to give them a hike in the position for negotiation. So these are the various roles which managers play. They may play one role today, they may play many roles in one day, and some of the roles may be prominent in one particular position. In some other position, in some other post, those roles may not be so important. I hope I have been able to explain these 10 managerial roles very clearly.